wanted to kind of do this aging thing gracefully. So
you
I
know
said,
now
I,
that you mentioned aging gracefully, you know, I don't want to put your number out there, but I think because you are aging gracefully, and I think you could inspire someone, Lena.
Yeah.
Can you let them know the magic number of years?
For me,
how many summers have you had?
66 summers.
You've had 66 summers and 66 winters.
Yes.
And you are retired law enforcement officer.
I'm retired law enforcement. My husband's retired law enforcement. He's at the gym a couple of times a week with a trainer, so he's doing well. I'm doing well. I hope to drop a few more pounds before it's over. But at 100, I still want to be running Mount Rubio.
Come on. So you're eating healthy organic food that you grow in your yard. Now, you're originally from Florida, right?
I'm from Florida, mm-hmm. And ate all of the stuff that we Floridians eat. And all of us from the South, we know how we love to eat and how we like to prepare food. So now I'm trying to do a healthier diet. My husband has a little diabetes and all of the things that black men usually have. Mm-hmm. I am as healthy as a horse. I don't have anything wrong with me.
Wow, Lena.
So I'm...
What would you share with my Facebook family about health? Maybe someone that's not quite as enthusiastic about running and going to the gym every day. Maybe they can't grow food. What is the easiest way just to start a healthier lifestyle?
I think you got to move. The one thing you don't want to do as you get older is not move. You
okay.
need to get up
you
and
gotta move.
You got to move.
I love that.
You got to move. And if you're just walking around the block, walk. That is the best thing for us. It doesn't cost any money. I mean, you know, get you a good pair of shoes and socks.
Very good.
And walk.
I love that because,
just
you know,
walking.
A lot of us live with excuses. I don't have
yes.
the right clothes. I don't have the right
mm-hmm.
shoes. I don't have time to go to the gym. But outdoors is free.
Yes. And boy, it's so healthy. I mean, you feel so good when you go outside in the morning. And I'm an early morning person because I was raised with the mantra that the early bird catches the worm. And then I watch the birds out in the morning. And before daybreak, those birds are eating the worms.
Wow.
Because once the sunlight comes up, you don't get any more worms.
Isn't that
so? So I'm like, you know, you pay attention to what nature does and you try to do the same thing. You want to exercise every day. Keep moving. Get one of those little pedometers that counts your
how many
your,
steps do you do?
Average? Oh, I sometimes average 15,000. It
God.
Depends on what I'm
is
doing.
Is she inspiring
that
you? I hope so. She's inspiring me.
Yeah, even when you're watching TV, you can do something. Get some little lightweight weights or get a can of vegetables or
right.
something and just move. If you're worried about those arms, move. And you don't have to lift a lot of weights.
Mm-hmm.
You just move. You can go in your kitchen and find stuff. I take my grandbabies and lift them up.
Come on.
They think it's so funny. I put them on my legs and do leg lifts with them.
Yes.
I bicycle with my granddaughter. She thinks that's absolutely wonderful. But the kids keep me so busy. If you just pick them up and just start lifting them, you know, it's just fun. I think they inspire me more than anything because they have so much energy.
You know, Lena, I think so often we focus on calories, we focus on having the right tennis shoes, but I like what you said. It's just about movement.
Move.
We are such a sedentary society. We sit in front of the computer, sit in front of the television. We want the closest parking space when we go to the store, and it's all about movement and getting those joints healthy.
Exactly. And I see so many, unfortunately, so many of our people who are now having knee surgeries and back surgeries. And I remember when I was going to physical therapy for the arthritis in my knee,
mm-hmm.
and the therapist said, lose 10 pounds.
Mm.
She says, losing 10 pounds is like taking 40 pounds off of your knees.
Isn't
because
that
our,
something?
Because our knees and our feet and our ankles are carrying all of our weight. And so I look at this and I'm looking and I know a lot of people like the medical profession and I do too. I think God ordained that. That's for us. But I can't push a pill and take a pill for everything when I have some control over my own life.
Absolutely.
I can control my diet. I can control my weight. And it's not that hard to do. We're going to have to give up. You know, there's sacrifices. I have to give up certain things, but once I get used to it, I'm a yogurt eater. I love fresh everything. I'm a fruit vegetable person.
I'm not a meat eater.
Probably salmon for me. Hubby might, he'll have salmon too and broccoli.
Is it broccoli from your garden?
And broccoli is not from my garden this year, but I did raise broccoli last year,
okay.
So I kind of rotate my crops.
Uh-huh.
But broccoli and sweet potato.
Wow, look at that. You're getting messages.
Yeah.
You are an inspiration, Lena.
Yeah.
This is Lena Robinson. part of my Women on the Grow tribe. She's one of my dream team leaders. She's a deaconess here at our church. We are sitting here in the community room after church. We had such an awesome service today. If you're ever in the Fontana area, come and visit New Life Christian Church here in Fontana. Pastor Sam Casey is our senior pastor, and it's a wonderful fellowship, very family-oriented, very real, very comfortable. Yes. This is a place where you can come and be fed the Word of God and just be, and plug into some spiritual power so that you can activate your faith, so that you can motivate yourself to walk in your purpose, so that you can be empowered in the body of Christ to be all that God intended you to be. This is a wonderful place, isn't it, Lena?
Oh, awesome.
I am so happy to be a part of this kingdom building.
Yes.
Lena and her husband are critical. We don't call ourselves members. We are disciples of this community church. And we are taping today from New Life Christian Community Church in Fontana, California. I'm Jewel Diamond Taylor, and I'm interviewing today Miss Lena Robinson, and she has shared with us some wonderful health tips. She grows her own food. She's running every week, exercising, moving, raising her grandchildren, retired, but not expired.
No, no way. I'm working harder now than I did when I was getting paid.
We love you, and I want to say to you, stay in the light. Thank you for tuning in today, and remember to visit my website, jeweldiamondtaylor.com.
Awesome.